Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome again to Sunday School. This morning's topic is going to be God is with Moses and Joshua. I want you to meet two men who are servants of God. They were Israelites, and they did their best to obey God. So this morning, I want you to get your Bibles, get a cozy place, and let us share the Word of God together. Let us pray. Our God and our Father, we come before you today because we know you're great. We know you're holy. We know you're righteous. We know that, Lord Jesus, we cannot do without you. And whatever we do or say, we depend on you. So this morning, Father God, as we depend on you to inspire our hearts unto wisdom, I pray that you will come in our midst. You will bless us. You will guide us. Please bless these of your young ones as they listen and learn more about thee. These mercies we ask, we glorify thee and give thee thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. So boys and girls, here we are. Our focus for today is we know God is always with us. So let's get into the scripture. Today, our lesson comes to us from Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 1 through 8, and verse 14 through 23. Also from Deuteronomy chapter 34, reading from verse 1 to 10, and Joshua chapter 1. Now, this is a very long story, so what I will do is I will share the story with you, and then you could read it along with your parents. Okay. So, remember, our story is about Joshua and Moses. And our memory verse for today comes from Joshua chapter 24, verse 15. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Let's say it again. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua 24, verse 15. Okay, so meet Moses. Moses, as I told you, was a servant of God. Joshua was his aide. That means Joshua was his helper. Now, the book from which the story comes is from Deuteronomy and Joshua. Those books are in the Old Testament. It's the fifth and sixth book of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, then Deuteronomy, and Joshua. So let's talk about Moses a little bit. In last week's lesson, you learn about Moses. Now Moses, as I told you, was a servant of God. And in last week's lesson, you learned that he sent 12 spies into the land of Canaan. Now, land of Canaan, was described as the promised land. It was a land that God was going to give to his people, the Israelites. The Israelites were God's chosen people. But the Israelites were suffering because the Egyptians had made them into slaves. So God had promised to do good to the Israelites, and he gave them a promise through Moses that he was going to give them a beautiful land. a land that was flowing with milk and honey. Now Moses did such a brave thing by sending the spies into the land of Canaan. That was so courageous, which we're going to talk about courage this morning. What is courage? Let's talk about it. What do you know about courage? When we say someone is courageous, what do we mean? Boys and girls, think about it. When someone is courageous, they do acts of bravery. Yes. So doing something without fear is called an act of bravery. And we say a person who carries out brave acts is considered to be courageous. Look at those pictures right here. The lady is attempting to snatch at a fierce animal. The firefighters are attempting to spray all that place that had been consumed with fire. So we decide that they are brave. And so is this gentleman trying to jump from one mountain to another. That is so incredible. So this morning, we're talking about bravery. And we say, Moses was so brave by sending those 12 spies into the land of Canaan. Now, let's think of some other things that are considered courageous. Boys and girls, let's look at these points here. Racing into a burning building to save lives. Is that courageous? Yes, it is. Thumbs up. Helping a person who is being robbed. That is so courageous. Confronting a bully or standing up for someone who is being picked on. Sometimes we have to be courageous and do that. Rosa Parks, she was a woman who was refusing to give her seat up on a bus because someone didn't like the color of her skin. And so she was courageous in standing up for herself. And then Martin Luther King, you must have heard about Martin Luther King in your studies. He stood up for equal rights and justice. That is courageous. And more than all, Christ Jesus, who, although he was continuing to be beaten, to be beat upon, he followed his faith, his beliefs, and his mission. Despite being hung on a cross, brutally beaten, and attacked, he remained courageous. And so today, we can get our inspiration from these acts, especially from Jesus, because he was the most courageous of all. So the story goes on about Moses. And remember, we said Moses was a man of God. Moses was called by God to lead the Israelites out of their bondage or out of their trouble, out of their problems, out of their slavery in Egypt. So Moses goes to Pharaoh, who was the leader of Egypt, and says to Pharaoh, "My God wants you to let his people go." Pharaoh chased him away and said, "I will not let these people go." The Egyptians didn't like the Israelites because they thought the Israelites were becoming greater in numbers than they were. And so they hated the Israelites and they worked them and beat them all day long. But God had promised to deliver the Israelites. And so the story goes on. There were many plagues in Israel, in Egypt, because the Egyptians would not let the people go. And so God had to send many plagues onto the Egyptians. There were flies all over the place. The animals died out. Their River Nile turned into blood. All kinds of things happened to them. But the Pharaoh was unwilling to let go the people of God out of Egypt. There were 10 different plagues, boys and girls. And still, Pharaoh's heart was so hard that he wouldn't let the people go. Each time he promised he would let them go, he changed his mind. He was not like God, who doesn't change his promises. The River Nile turned into blood. There were frogs everywhere upon the land. Gnats developed everywhere. Flies covered in all the houses of the Egyptians. Their livestock, some of them died out. But still, the Egyptians did not want to let the people go. God continued to put plagues upon them. Boils came upon their skins. Hail from heaven poured down on the earth. And they still wouldn't let the people go. Each time Pharaoh promised, he changed his promise and hardened his heart some more. There were locusts upon the land. There was darkness upon the land. Even their firstborn died out. And he still wouldn't let the people go. He still held on to the Israelites because he still wanted to keep them as slaves. But one day, after all that had happened, finally, Pharaoh decided to let the Israelites go. After Moses going to him repeatedly to say, "Let the Israelites go." So finally, he decided to let the Israelites go. And the Israelites took all their belongings and they left Egypt. They were so joyful. Just look how happy they were. So their leader Moses was with them. And Moses' task was to take them across to the promised land. But they had to go through a wilderness. And in front of them was the Red Sea. And they were wondering, how are we going to get across this Red Sea? It is so big and so dangerous before us. But Moses trusted God. Moses had seen God work before. Moses always took along with him a rod. And Moses has seen sometime before that God asked him to throw down the rod and it became a serpent, a snake. And then he asked him to pick it up again and it became a rod. So Moses knew that God has given him power. So when Moses got to the Red Sea and everybody was wondering, why did Moses take us here? Are you going to let us drown into the sea? Moses held out his rod and the seas rolled up and separate. And as soon as the seas separate, God's people were able to go over on dry land. And so all the people journeyed through the length of the Red Sea and dry land. Boys and girls, can you imagine that? All the people went over on dry land. So, right after they went over on dry land, Pharaoh changed his mind and decided he was going to chase after the Israelites with his army of men and soldiers and horses, because he was determined to bring them back as slaves. But as soon as they journeyed right after the Israelites, God waited until all the Israelites had cleared through on dry land through the path of the sea. And the Egyptians were in the midst of it. They all drowned. So God took care of his people. Then here is, after they got into the wilderness, they were there so long and God was taking care of them. until one day Moses got up and said, "People of God, I cannot be your leader anymore. I am too old. I am now 120 years old. I can no longer be your leader. God is going to help me to appoint a new leader." The people were sorrowful, but they accepted the new leader that God was appointing them. His name was Joshua. And so Moses called Joshua. He blessed Joshua. He prayed over Joshua, and he decided that, "Joshua, it is now time for you to take up the mantle, because you are going to take the people across to the promised land." Moses, he didn't get to see the promised land because Moses did something that God was not pleased of while he was in the wilderness. And so God told Moses, "You will get to see the promised land, but you will not get to go over into it." And so God asked Moses to teach the people a song. And Moses stood up and taught the people the song. But God even told Moses that some of these people are going to try to forget him after all he had done for them. But Moses was brave, and Moses continued. Moses taught the people the song that God told him to teach them. And then God took Moses up into the mountain, and he showed him the beautiful promised land that he was going to give to them. Yet Moses could only see the land. He was not going to enter into the land. It was going to be Joshua who was going to lead the people of God when he took over from Moses. And so Moses spied the land and saw how beautiful it was. And they said the land was filled with honey. So Moses took a good look at the land. After that, Moses died at 120 years, and God buried him. After that, Joshua took over. It was so sad, and all the people wept. They cried for 30 days because they missed Moses, because they thought Moses was such a great leader. And then Joshua, he stood up and he was ready to lead the people. He was ready to take over from Moses. God said to Joshua, "You are going to cross this Jordan and you are going to possess the land." And so Joshua gathered everybody together, and there they were, crossing over Jordan and into the promised land of Canaan. They all journeyed, some carrying the Ark of the Covenant, people carrying different things that were God's precious gifts to them. And they crossed over the river Jordan and into the promised land, led by Joshua. God was good to them, and they all followed Joshua into the promised land. God had kept his promise to his people. And so the story says today that God is faithful. God had kept his promise to the Israelites. He promised them to rescue them from the Egyptians, to put them into a land filled with honey. And so God kept his promise. And today, God can keep his promise to you too, and to all of us who trust him and believe him. So let us see what we will remember from today's lesson. One, both Moses sent spies to the land of Canaan to check it out. Two, courage is an act of bravery. Egypt had to have 10 different plagues before Pharaoh decided to let go of God's people, the Israelites. God told Moses to stretch forth his rod, and the Red Sea parted. The children of Israel went across the Red Sea on dry land. Pharaoh's army that was chasing after them were all drowned in the Red Sea. Moses appointed a new leader when he got old, whose name was Joshua. Moses was able to view the promised land before he died and God buried him. But like I told you, Moses was not going to enter into the promised land. It was going to be Joshua who was going to take the people across. And Joshua led the people across to the promised land. God had kept his promise to his people. So you see, boys and girls, that God is able to keep us. God is able to protect us. God is able to take care of us. So I hope today from this lesson, you will learn that God is faithful and God can take care of you wherever you are. So this morning, I want you to remember the memory verse that says, "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Let's say it again. Joshua 24, verse 15. "As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord." Thank you for listening today, boys and girls. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope you remember that God is always with you and God will protect you. Continue to pray, continue to believe God, continue to trust in God, because he is able to take care of us all. Thank you, boys and girls, for listening. See you next time. Bye-bye.